जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी ऑल आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर कंपेयरिंग क्वांटिटीज। इन आर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी ऑल हैव स्टडीड अबाउट डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ कंपेयरिंग क्वांटिटीज एंड दैट वर अबाउट परसेंटेज, प्रॉफिट, loss, discount, etc. Now in today's class we are going to start with the last topic, and that is simple and compound interest. Basically we have to discuss about compound interest, but how they are different. For the same I have taken both of them. I have taken simple interest also and compound interest also. To understand the difference between simple and compound interest, we will first take an example and then we will discuss how are they different. So suppose a person invested rupees 10,000 to a bank for say 2 years at the rate of 10% per annum. Now if I want to find out the simple interest on rupees 10,000 for 2 years at the rate of 10% per annum, when the interest is paid at simple interest, then we know that the formula of simple interest is P into R into T by 100. So principal over here is 10,000. Rate is 10% per annum and time is 2 years divided by 100. So these two will cancel. We will get 2000. So the interest for 2 years on rupees 10,000 at the rate of 10% per annum simple interest will be rupees 2000. Why are we doing it directly for 2 years? Because every year the interest will be paid on rupees 10,000 only. Now if we go for compound interest, which means suppose if a person invested rupees 10,000 for 2 years at the rate of 10% per annum, but the interest is compounded annually, in that case what will be the total interest which the person receives after 2 years? For this we will calculate the interest year after year. We will not calculate the interest of all the years together, rather we will take the interest for first year and that will be PRT by 100. So P is 10,000, rate is 10% and time is 1 year for this case, divided by 100. So we'll get the interest for the first year is rupees 1000, which will be same as the simple interest on rupees 10,000 for 1 year. The difference arises when we start for the second year. Once the year has completed, the total money which will be there in the account will be equals to the money invested plus the interest obtained, and that will be equals to 11,000. Now the difference between simple interest and compound interest is this, that now for the second year the interest will be calculated on the amount which is present in the account till the end of the first year. So in this case the principal, instead of being 10,000, becomes 11,000. Rate will remain same and time is for 1 year. So if we calculate the interest for the second year, the principal will be 11,000, rate is 10% and time is 1 year. So when we simplify it, we will get ₹1,100 and the amount will be equals to the total amount which was present in the account plus the interest obtained, and that will be equals to ₹12,100. So here if you calculate the amount, it will come 10,000 plus 2,000, that is 12,000, and here it is 12,100. So that's the difference. In the case of compound interest, the interest is always calculated on the money which is present till that time when the interest is started. Every year, the principal amount will keep on increasing. Whereas in case of simple interest, it remains same for all the case. In fact, in Hindi, the compound interest is known as Chakravriddhi Vyas, which means every year there is an increment in the interest. And always remember, if the same amount for same time at the same rate of interest is invested in two ways, one when the interest is calculated as simple interest and the another when the interest is calculated compounded, the compound interest will always be greater than the simple interest. Now, let us try to understand how can we calculate compound interest. In case of a numerical problem. So let's take a question from the exercise only. So from the exercise 8.3, if I'll take the first question, I'm taking exercise 8.3, question number 1, and its first part. It is given that the principal amount is ₹10,800. Time over here is 3 years, and the rate of interest is 12/1/2% compounded annually. So here the time is 3 years, so we will calculate interest for all 3 years separately and then keep on adding it to the principal so as to get the amount at the end of that year. So we will start with the first part. We will calculate interest for first year, and that will be equals to principal, that is 10,800, multiplied by the rate. This rate can also be written as 25 by 2%. 12 to the 22 plus 125. So 25 time is 1 year. It was by 2, so 2 will come down, and upon 100, so this 100 will come here. Now we just need to simplify this to get the value of interest for the first year. So as you can see, we can simply cut these two zeros, and 2 ones are 2, and 2 fives are 10, and 4 times. So we have got 54 multiplied by 25. So when you multiply 54 into 25, we will get rupees 1350. This is the interest for the first year, and now we will calculate amount for first year, and that will be equals to the principal 10,800 plus the interest we have obtained, and when we add this, we will get rupees 12,150. So if it is given that the interest is paid for 1 year to be calculated, for the 1 year, the interest is rupees 1350, and then the total money which the person will have in his or her account at the end of the first year is 12,150. And now the same amount of the first year will be taken as principal for second year. So that will be equals to rupees 12,150. And now we will calculate the interest for second year. To do that, the principal will be 12,150. Rate is 25 by 2%, so 25 will come here, 2 will come down, time is 1 year, and it was divided by 100, so this is 100. Now these two will cancel out, and if we simplify it further, we will get it as 1215 into 25 divided by 20. So let us try to simplify it further. So once we simplify it, we will get this is equals to rupees 1518.75. So the interest for the second year is 1518 plus 0.75. We now calculate the amount for second year, which will be equals to the amount which was there at the end of first year, or the principal which was taken as the principal of second year, plus the interest, that is 12150 plus 1518.75. So when we simplify it, we will get this is equals to rupees 13,668.75. And now this will be taken as principal for third year. And now we calculate interest for the third year, and that will again be equals to PRT by 100. Principal over here will be 13,668.75. Rate is 25/2. Time is 1 year divided by 100. So now this is by 2. And now when we simplify it further, we will get 1,708.75, and then the final amount will be equals to 13,668.75 plus 1,708.59, and that when we add we will get is equals to 15,377.34. So this is the total amount which a person will receive at the end of 3 years, or after 3 years, when he or she invested ₹10,800 for 3 years at the rate of 12.12%. And also, if I need to calculate the compound interest, I simply have to subtract the principal from the amount. So we get is equals to ₹4,577.34. So this is the compound interest. With this, we come to the end of the today's class. I hope you all must have understood how to calculate the compound interest by using this. In the next class, we will try to understand how to do this in a shorter way. That means we'll try to find out a formula for finding out the compound interest. Till then, go through this thoroughly. If you have any question, you can ask me. By the time, happy learning. Jai Hind.